Hey, hello guys, welcome to a new episode of .Netflix. Today we have a very special guest from Microsoft, Sarya Das. Sarya, maybe you can introduce yourself.
Thank you so much for the opportunity. Hi, my name is Sarya Das and I'm a program manager at Microsoft. I work in the Azure Linux Compute team. I focus on Azure Container Service, the Azure CLI, and then a bunch of other open source stuff. My background is being in Java development, architect for about 7 to 8 years. I worked for Oracle Corporation and Huawei Technologies. And then I'm excited to be a part of Microsoft's journey in the open source space.
Yeah, that's a great move. We are also very excited about it as developers and users of Microsoft products.
But that's great.
We think it's a great move, and we benefit a lot from it.
Yes,
also,
absolutely.
What was introduced, the bash shell on Windows. I think that
how cool
is
that?
That is so cool.
It's very awesome.
So, we saw a very interesting talk by you yesterday on Azure Container Services. Can you tell us a little bit more about that?
Yeah, so Azure Container Service is like, it's a special service. What it is essentially with the click of a few buttons and a few entries, you can start up a cluster of hosts and with an orchestrator that will orchestrate these clusters for you, containers for you.
Okay.
And all you need to do is focus on building your application and deploying on it.
Okay.
And then managing the, scaling up and down via the, the orchestrators that we provide. So let me go into a little bit of detail. So what Azure Container Service is at the bottom layer, it's the infrastructure.
Mm-hmm.
We define it in three layers. The middle layer is the orchestrator, and the top layer is your application layer.
Okay.
So at the bottom layer, you have your virtual machines. Virtual machines, virtual machine skill sets. Are you guys aware of virtual machine skill sets?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, spinning up 100 VMs. You don't care about, the infrastructure.
It's just kettle, right?
It's, it's kettle.
Yeah.
So we, as a part of Azure Container Service, you just given the number of, we call them agents. As a part of the cluster, and you just say how many you want to bring them up, and we'll bring them up for you. Then there is the orchestrator layer. Today, we provide support for Docker Swarm and Apache Mesos.
Okay.
So you could choose either of the framework for your orchestrator. So we've hidden the code of bringing all of these infrastructure up, the networking, the storage, and the orchestrator. We've worked with Mesosphere and Docker to kind of take these thousands and thousands of lines of code into just an easy, like, 5 lines of ARM template.
Yeah,
and you just fill them out, and then you are ready to start.
Cool. So all this work I used to do, I needed to do to get my machines up and running, install Mesosphere, configure everything, that's all done by Azure Container
Service. All done by Azure. The cool thing here is we want to keep it as open as possible.
Mm-hmm.
So if you see our three layers, we build up the infrastructure, we allow you to select one of the two orchestrators that you have today, and that's all it is.
Exactly.
So you use the orchestrator if you have Docker Swarm. If you want to build a stack that is only Docker native, you can do that.
Yeah.
And if you want to use Mesos, Mesos has been proven. It's it's a proven orchestrator.
Yeah.
It's been used heavily in Twitter, Airbnb, in Apple Siri. It's been used in production environment.
Yeah.
Very proven. So
mm-hmm.
you don't need to change anything. People using Mesos can use Mesos. People
exactly.
want to use Swarm, they can use Swarm.
Yeah.
So it's up to you guys to use them to scale your containers.
Nice.
Okay. So and this is all on Linux, or is there also
this
Windows?
Is everything on Linux. The version of Ubuntu that we use is 14.04. LTS.
Yeah.
It's that specific.
Okay.
Okay.
So.
Yeah. Okay. And what you spin up are Docker containers. So if you have Docker files and build files for your Docker containers already, can you reuse all that stuff and all your knowledge that you have around Docker?
Essentially, that's what it is. So the containers come, the cluster comes up, and then you just kind of SSH into one of the masters, and then you build your application.
Okay.
Docker Engine is already installed on it.
Nice.
You can start running all the Docker commands.
Okay. Yeah, and also what we saw in the talk yesterday was that there is something that's called the SSH tunnel.
Yes.
And for us as real Windows guys, it's a little bit iffy. What is that, an SSH tunnel? Could you go into that, what that does and why that is necessary?
Yeah, so at this point, to network, to kind of get into the machines that we've just spun up, we use SSH. It's just a secure shell. It's an encrypted protocol to network, to log over the network to log into a machine and do work on it.
Exactly.
We are working to bring in like a UI or something in the future, but we're still getting feedback. In the next cycle, we'll probably have something easier for users to go in and do work on. Something UI, something visible, visual. Hopefully.
Yeah, and it's actually to make sure that the commands that you're typing on your terminal are actually executed within the cluster on the machines.
Yes.
Exactly.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah. Very nice.
So this is a very nice platform to run microservices in containers. Microsoft also has Service Fabric, yes, which we can use to run, yes, microservices. Can, yeah, you talk a little bit about the relation between the two?
Yes, the way we like to position Service Fabric is like, Service Fabric comes at the, so this is the spectrum, okay? This is IaaS on the left, mm-hmm, and we have PaaS on the right, mm-hmm, and then we have on the left, bare bones virtual machine, virtual skill sets, and then comes ACS in between.
Okay.
Service Fabric is actually a full-blown PaaS solution.
Yeah, exactly.
You don't need to bother about the infrastructure at all. You don't need to do anything, any management.
No.
No management, nothing at all. You just focus on building your application using microservices,
yeah,
and then right, you're good. Yeah. One thing about Service Fabric, how it is different from Azure Container Service, is that you can build stateless and stateful applications.
Mm-hmm.
It's a little hard to manage stateful applications on Azure Containers.
Yeah. And with Azure Containers, you're still talking about machines or containers, but with Azure Service Fabric, it's actually services. It's pieces of software, yeah, that you deploy. So it's a level up from ACS.
Exactly. It's a full-blown PaaS solution,
yeah,
as I put,
yeah,
it. Like,
okay,
you are focused on building your application, adding value to your business. You don't care about any infrastructure.
Exactly.
No. And it's actually kind of, if you look at it, it's, you are on the hooks of, it's a Microsoft solution.
Yeah.
And it they don't run on containers.
Right.
No.
So that's the key difference.
Exactly.
And then what happens is they have other other things that they that come with, bells and whistles that come with it. Health of the,
mm-hmm,
of your whatever application.
Yeah,
monitoring stuff.
Yeah.
They do the upgrades for you. They manage everything. You,
yeah,
do not need to worry.
Domains and stuff,
domains
like
that. Domains and
backs,
everything.
Yeah.
So, more stuff is done for you, but you're basically less flexible.
You're less flexible.
I can take my microservices built on Service Fabric and decide now I want to run this on Google or in the Amazon Cloud.
You could possibly run that, but you would have to kind of build the same infrastructure around.
Right.
Exactly. So it is harder.
Yeah.
Okay.
But yeah, so they are kind of Azure Container Service and Service Fabric are kind of targeted at different set of customers.
Mm-hmm.
That's where we put it. But it is a cool service.
Okay. Yeah. Great. Well, thanks for talking to us today. We love the services that we get from you guys, and there are more services coming, but we love to use them. So
yes, absolutely. I encourage you to go try Azure Container Service if you haven't already, and we look forward to your feedback. Thank
awesome.
You so much.
Thanks very much.
Thank you.
I hope you guys enjoyed this, and maybe see you for our next episode of .NET Flix. Later.
Bye-bye.